So let us begin by understanding the homotopy property of vector models. So we want to show that if Y is a smooth manifold, and E is a vector bundle on Y cross R, then the two bundles E restricted to Y cross A and E restricted to Y cross B are isomorphic. So these are bundles on Y for all A, comma B and R. So we will give a proof only in the case when Y is compact. Although we will use it more generally, use the more general statement. So in this case, so assume Y is compact. Let P be a point in R. Let I from Y cross R to Y denote a projection. So, for simplicity of notation, let us denote the bundle E restricted to Y cross P on Y by E sub P. So consider the bundle pi upper star E sub P dual tensor E. And let's call this bundle G. So notice that fiber wise, so if so G is a bundle on, then G is a bundle on Y cross R, and the fiber over a point, or yeah, the phi, and not the fiber, G restricted to Y cross, let's say Q, is isomorphic to pi upper star EP tensor EP dual tensor E, which is isomorphic to the bundle Hom pi upper star EP comma E on Y. So for each point, Y in Y, there is a neighborhood. There are neighborhoods U sub Y containing Y and V sub Y containing P. So U sub Y is contained in Y and V sub Y is contained in R. such that G is trivial on U sub y times V sub y. Since y is compact, we can find finitely many UIs which cover Y. And a neighborhood V containing P inside R such that G is trivial on UI cross V. So we can simply take V to be the intersection of the V sub I's. So write G restricted to U sub I cross V. This is the trivial bundle, so we can write it as UI cross V cross Rn. Let's say the bundle has, sorry, rank n square. So if E is the bundle of rank n, then it's clear that G is a bundle of rank n square. So there is a section of G restricted to UI cross V corresponding to the identity map. So this is G restricted to UI cross P. Corresponding to the identity map. So extend, so let's just understand this. So G restricted to G restricted to Y cross P isomorphic to pi upper star E sub P dual tensor E sub P. So this implies we have the identity section. So in we have the identity section. So we are just taking the restriction of that section to UI. So, and so as we saw before, G restricted to UI cross V is isomorphic to UI cross V cross Rn square. So we can extend this function, this section on u cross ui cross p to all of ui cross v by taking it to be constant. Constant in the second coordinate. That is in the Rn square. So thus we get a section Si in gamma ui cross v comma g. So let y prime be equal to y cross v. So this is a submanifold of y cross r. And let Fi be a partition of unity subordinate to Ui cross V. Then consider the section S in gamma y cross v comma g given by summation fi si. So there is clearly a smooth section of g on all of y cross v, and moreover the restriction S restricted to y cross p corresponds to the identity map. In pi up star ep dual tensor e sub. Thus there is a neighborhood. So this is by using tube lemma of P. Since Y is compact, say V prime says that S is an isomorphism for all Q in V prime. That is so we have an element of pi upper star, we have a section of this bundle on Y cross V, Y cross V prime, and when I take any point Q inside V prime, this section gives rise to a map from pi upper star E sub P to E restricted to Y cross Q. This is a map of bundles over Y, and this is an isomorphism. So now consider the compact set A comma B and R applying the above for all P in A comma B, we see that there is a sequence, a finite sequence of isomorphisms. E restricted to Y cross A is isomorphic to E restricted to Y cross P1 is isomorphic to, and so on, isomorphic to E restricted to Y cross Pn, which is equal to E restricted to Y cross P. So this proves, so this completes the proof that if Y is compact, and E is a bundle on Y cross R, then E restricted to Y cross A is isomorphic to E restricted to Y cross B for all A and B in R. However, the theorem is true much more generally. Now let's just write this down. So let Y be a smooth manifold. And let E be a smooth bundle on Y cross R. Then E restricted to Y cross A is isomorphic to E restricted to Y cross B for all A comma B in R. And as a corollary, you see the following. Suppose we have two homotopic maps F and G from Y to X, then F upper star E is isomorphic to G upper star E for all bundles E on X. So proof of the corollary is easy proof. So let F be a homotopy from Y cross R to X. So let F such that F sub 0 is F and F sub 1 is equal to G. So then F upper star E is isomorphic to F upper star E restricted to Y cross 0 and F up G upper star E is isomorphic to F upper star E restricted to Y cross 1. And from the previous theorem, we know that these two are isomorphic. So we will use this discussion to prove in proof of Thom isomorphism, which is what we are headed towards. So cohomology of vector models. So let pi from E to M be a vector bundle . So clearly E deformation retracts onto the zero section . Thus a when we regard E as a smooth manifold. I mean, yeah. So the cohomologies are isomorphic. So what can we say? About, okay, let me just make this statement more precise. So, I mean, M is sitting inside E as the zero section, and the map S naught upper star induces an isomorphism. What can we say about compact cohomology? Cohomology with compact supports. So let's assume, so suppose both E and M are orientable. And we fix an orientation on both of them, and M is a finite type. Then E is also a finite type. This is because if we take a good cover for M, so if UI is a good cover for M, then pi inverse UI is a good cover for E. So here we will use that every vector bundle. Rn is trivial since Rm is contractible. So that is the previous result that we used. So therefore we have, so this is something, the proof of which we have seen, that if M is an orientable manifold of finite type, then Poincaré duality holds for it. So this is the dimension of E. This is where Poincaré duality on E. This is isomorphic to, yes, when we pull back to the zero section. And this is isomorphic to This point here you are doing. So recall. Okay, so next. So we see, so we give a criterion for when a vector bundle is orientable. Or rather, we give examples of orientable vector bundles. So recall that a vector bundle pi from E to M is called oriented. It's called an oriented vector bundle if it can be constructed by gluing using transition functions into GLNR plus. So here's a lemma. Let E be an oriented vector bundle over an orientable manifold. Then E is an orientable manifold. So proof. So let UI be an open cover for M by coordinate open sets over which E is trivial. So that is, we are assuming E restricted to UI is trivial. So suppose the gluing functions for E are given by psi ij from uij to glnr plus, and m is glued using maps phi ij from uij to uji. Then if pi from E to M what's the bundle map? Inverse UI is an open cover. By coordinate open sets. For E. And the gluing maps. Are given by inverse uij is equal to uij plus rn to uji cross rn. This is by inverse uji. And these maps are, let's call these maps eta ijs. This sends x comma v to phi ij x comma psi ij x comma v. So strictly speaking, we should put maybe uij tilde over here or something like that. So let me just explain this notation here. So M is obtained by gluing UIs on UIJs. So let UI tilde denote the image of UI in M, then UIJ tilde is equal to UJI tilde is equal to image of UIJ, image of UJI. Okay, so let x1 xm, y1 yn denote coordinates on uij cross rn and let x1 prime, xm prime, y1 prime, ym prime denote coordinates on uji cross rn for simplicity. Of notation, let us denote eta ij by eta. So, so we may write, so that P be a point in uij cross rn and we may write t eta at P of t by txi at P in terms of t by txi prime at eta of P and T by T by J prime at eta of P as column vectors. And similarly, so basically we are computing the differential for theta p d by j at p. So we check easily. That this matrix is of the form P5 at P can be anything here, 0. And here is precisely psi of p. So recall that eta of x comma b was equal to phi of x comma psi of x. So we have omitted the indices ij of v, and psi of x is a linear map. Since M is orientable, so this means that we can choose coordinates such that M is orientable is exactly same as saying that the tangent bundle is orientable, which means we can choose coordinates as that determinant of d phi p is positive for all p, and since E is an orientable vector bundle, and since E is an oriented vector bundle, by definition, determinant of psi of P is strictly greater than 0 for all P. So this implies that on E, we have chosen coordinates. So that in a way such that d eta determinant of at p is positive. Well, for all. This implies that E is orientable as a manifold. So this completes the proof. Okay. So next we want to define compact vertical cohomology. And integration along fibers. So let pi from A to M be a vector bundle. We will define H star compact vertical of E. So a section S in an R form. So we view E as a smooth manifold, and an R form S is said to be in gamma CV. So this is a subspace if for any compact K inside M, the set by inverse K intersected with support of S is compact. Since support of T times S is contained in support of S, it follows that we get a subcomplex. So now let us state some generalities. So before we state those generalities, so this implies the cohomology, right? The cohomology of the complex. Is denoted by H. So some generalities. About vector models. Let 0 to E, E prime to E to E prime prime to 0 be a short exact sequence. Of vector bundles. On a manifold M. Then for each R strictly greater than or equal to 0, we have a filtration of exterior RE such that Fi mod Fi plus 1 is isomorphic to exterior R minus I E prime prime tensor exterior I E prime. And a similar statement holds for SR. The proof of this is left as an exercise. So for a bundle E, on M, so we have a surjective map of bundles. Sorry, from the tangent bundle of E to pi upper star in the tangent bundle of M, this is surjective. And taking the kernel, we get a short exact sequence. Zero k tangent bundle pi upper star dm to zero. So when we take dual of this, taking dual of this, we get a short exact sequence. Zero pi star omega m omega e to k dual zero. So we apply the preceding generality. And the short exact sequence. So let n be equal to rank of e, and let r be greater than or equal to n. Then there is a filtration. On exterior r omega e, f0, f1, and so on. Okay, how do I write this sub r? Okay, so maybe I should. I'm using. Such that if I want phi plus 1 stereo r minus I k dual tensor exterior I pi upper star omega. So the RHS is zero if r minus I is strictly greater than n, which is equivalent to saying that r minus n is strictly greater than I. So what this means is that if I is strictly less than r minus n, then fi is equal to fi plus 1. So in particular, so since we are assuming, since we have assumed r minus n is greater than or equal to 0, we have f0 is equal to f1. Goes all the way up to f r minus n, and f r minus n mod f r minus n plus 1 is isomorphic to exterior n k dual tensor exterior r minus n pi upper star omega. Thus, we have a surjection. So F0 is equal to F R minus N. So let me write exterior R omega E is equal to F0 equal to F R minus N 2 F R minus N mod F R minus N plus 1. This is equal to exterior N K dual tensor exterior R minus N pi plus tau omega. Locally, if we choose coordinates, x1 up to xm on M and t1 to tn on the fibers. The surjection projects two forms. Which have dt1 wedge dtn as a factor. So if omega is in CV, E comma exterior omega E CR, we define a map pi lower star as follows. So we just integrate out this top form on the fiber. That's roughly the idea. Pi lower star omega x at a point x in M. Integral over pi inverse x. Phi of omega. So here phi of omega at x. So phi is this projection map. So let us describe this locally. And check this well defined. So we choose a coordinate open set U over which E is trivial. Let x1 through xm be coordinates in the base and let t1 to tn be coordinates on the fiber. So let us assume that omega is of the form f of x comma t dxi h dt1 h dtn. So it is enough to consider so right now we are only describing this locally, so let's just assume omega is of this form and pi lower star omega is equal to integral over Rn f of x comma t dt1 to dtn times dxi. Suppose x1 prime, x2 prime, up to x m prime, and t1 prime, t2 prime, tm prime are another set of coordinates as above. And let u cross Rn phi tilde u cross Rn is x prime comma t prime maps to phi of x prime comma psi of x prime t prime. So here psi is a map from U to G, L, and R. Be the coordinate change map. This shows that xi is equal to phi of x prime, phi I of x prime, and ti is equal to summation j psi x ji dj prime. So let us compute pi lower star of phi tilde upper star omega. So phi tilde upper star of omega is equal to f compose phi tilde of x prime comma t prime t xi compose phi tilde, but that's just xi compose phi I1 dx. I2 compose phi h dx ir compose phi which d summation j psi of x j I is 1, sorry. So, any term which does not contain dt1 prime wedge dtn prime gets mapped to 0. Then we apply Poiseuille star. So when we open up the RHS, so the terms which, so let's just look at this thing. So there's X prime. This equal to and the terms involving T psi xji do not appear because if any term involving d psi xji appears, then that would mean that dt1 up to dtn is not going to be a factor. So thus, phi lower star, phi tilde upper star, omega is equal to integral over Rn f impose phi tilde x prime d prime determinant of psi of x d d1 wedge dt into d xi1 compose phi wedge dxir compose phi. And if E is an oriented vector bundle, so then we always choose the coordinates so that the transition functions have positive determinant. Thus, phi lower star, phi tilde upper star, omega is equal to. So we just do the change of variables formula for integration, phi f x prime comma t dt1 which ddn t xi1 compose phi which t xir compose phi. And this is exactly equal to phi upper star of pi lower star omega. So this is for forms which contain dt1 which dtn as a factor. For forms which do not contain this as a factor, note that pi lower star omega is defined to be 0 since when we project to exterior n k dual tensor exterior r minus n omega e, we get 0. And the important thing to note that in this case phi tilde upper star omega will not have dt1 d prime 1 which d d prime n as a factor. So this implies that pi lower star of phi tilde upper star omega is also 0. So now bilinearity of pi lower star. So this implies that for any form omega in C compact vertical exterior R omega E, so maybe we can summarize this by making a remark about the oriented structure on E. So we summarize this as follows. Let E be an oriented vector bundle on M. Fix an orientation on E and let S1 Sn be any oriented trivialization. So by this we mean the following. So E is oriented implies determinant of E minus the determinant of E is trivial, is E oriented implies determinant E is trivial. Fix a component of determinant of E minus the zero section. A trivialization S1 up to Sn of E is called oriented if S1 which Sn is in the trivialization we fixed, is in the component. Of determinant of E that we fixed. So then define pi lower star from gamma CV E. Then we can define pi lower star compact vertical pi inverse u exterior r omega e to comma u comma exterior r minus n omega u as before so that is f omega. So the type f x comma t txi which t t1 ttn t1 up to tn oriented trivialization for e. Then pi lower star omega is equal to integral so let's say pi lower star omega x DXI. And if T T1 TTN is not a factor of omega, then pi lower star omega is defined to be 0. So then we checked that these maps glue together to give a map pi lower star e comma omega e so let us end here.